everyone. I'm Ashley. Welcome to another Watch Me Wednesday video. Today is June the 22nd, and since we are getting right into the swing of summer, I thought I'd do something for the upcoming holiday, Independence Day. I'm thinking about having a few family and friends over, so I thought it would be really cool to do some invitations for them, something different, not just pick up the phone and say, hey, can you guys come over today at 2 o'clock, right? So I'm going to generate an invitation for you, and usually what I do is I get the general design scheme down first, and that's my template. I call it my template, and then I like to do everything in steps after that when I make them. So I may do all the cuts, the first step. The second step may be doing all the die cutting. The third step may be stamping, and then the final step could be just compiling it and adhering everything all together. So another tip is to make sure that you have enough materials to complete all of your invitations, and keep in mind the bulk or the size of the invitation in respect to shipping costs. You don't want to get to the post office and be surprised at how outrageous the shipping costs may be because of the size or the bulkiness of your invitations. And I also keep in mind the simplicity factor of it because, as I said before, I like to create them in steps, but you don't want to do too many steps or overwhelm yourself. So you want to make sure it's a pretty simplified invitation enough for you so you won't get overwhelmed. So those are my tips and tricks for creating invitations for a special event or a holiday or a little shindig at your house. So I'm going to go ahead and get started on my design template, and thanks so much for joining me. So let's go ahead and get started. Here's the 4th of July invitation that I'll be sharing how I created today. First thing I did is had a 5-inch square craft cardstock cut. And I already have here the invitation printed out on a 4 3/4-inch square white cardstock. And I just generated that using Photoshop CS5, but you can use Microsoft Word just as easy too. And I use different fonts. All the fonts can be found on my and the supplies on my blog today. So I'm just adding some adhesive to the back of the white cardstock, and I'm just going to go ahead and adhere it right to this Enchanted Evening or navy blue cardstock. Now I'm grabbing my Pinking Shears by Fiskars, and I'm going to do a border around it so it looks kind of like firecrackery, I think. I'm just going to trim the excess off here so I'll have enough room to work with. Alright, now that the excess is trimmed, I'm just going to go ahead and just start at one end. And I like to use my Pinking Shears all the way at the end as possible so I get a full trim. And then I line it back up again, similar as you would do with a border punch. And just trim again. And usually I can go all the way to the end. That time I didn't do that right. But on this one, I'm going to try a little bit better. So I go all the way to the end, and I snip all the way, and I don't want to go all the way to the end of the shear because it kind of has a different zigzaggy edge there. It doesn't really finish right. All right, and then my third border here, just going through. The cool thing about Pinking Shears and that zigzag pattern is it doesn't have to be like completely straight and even. The naked eye doesn't catch it as easily as a straight line, so I like that about using Pinking Shears. All right, now that that's all cut, it adds a little bit of pizzazz here to my invitation. I said like a firecrackery type of border there. So I'm going to go ahead and add some adhesive to the back of this cardstock and mat it right on the craft 5-inch square base there. All right, now I have a strip of red polka dot patterned paper, and I'm going to die cut this number 4 from the navy cardstock. And here's the number 4, and I'm just going to try to figure out the placement here where I want it on the front of the invitation. I think it's... I'm trying to figure out here what I want to use. I know I want to use the TH here, so it'll read 4. So I'm just going to put that TH stamp right on my acrylic block here, and then I can position it exactly where I want. So I'm trimming the red polka dot pattern paper down to about 1 inch wide because it was a bit too wide for the number 4, how I wanted it to appear. So now I can see here that it pops off the edge there, but it fits onto the pattern. So I think I'm going to place it right there. But before I do, I'm just going to go ahead and snip a triangle out the ends of this pattern paper strip, and that's so it can create like a fun banner here, and I think that's really festive for Independence Day. Lots of banners and flags during that day, so I thought this would be a good thing to incorporate into the invitation. So instead of having the banner kind of sit within the 5-inch square, I'm going to have it come off of the square because it just looks a little bit better that way. Okay, I'm just going to add some adhesive and then adhere it right to the front of the invitation. And that wasn't placed properly, so I'm just going to peel it up and then put it right back down. And I put it right back down over the part where it made any kind of mistake, so you won't see that anyway. Alright, so I have my number 4 back here again, and I'm just going to figure out the placement. I think I want it right here, and I'm going to get my stamp and get out my outdoor denim close to my heart ink, which is like a navy ink. Ink the TH up, and then I'm going to stamp it right in the upper right hand corner where the 4 will be placed. All right, so these foam adhesive mounts aren't very thick at all, and they are perfect for shipping purposes, which is why I'm using them on this one. And they give it some dimension and height, but not too much, where that the person at the post office will say, it can't fit into the little slot, you're gonna have to pay 60 cents extra, or whatever it is. So hopefully this would still work great. So look for thin foam adhesive when you want to use foam adhesive and still ship. All right, here's some chipboard letters by Basic Gray. They're little minis. They already are self-adhesive, but I like to add some liquid adhesive to the backs of them to make sure they stay down. I find that sometimes these chipboard letters Even though the self-adhesive seemed like it sticks, it doesn't quite stick good enough for me. So I like to give it a little bit more adhesive, and so I'm using my Helmar's acid-free liquid adhesive here. It dries clear, so I might have a little bit oozing out there, but it dries clear. And for the last letter is a Y. All right, just gonna let that dry. And the last step I'm gonna do is to take some sticker letters and just type in, not type, but adhere the word of right through here. And that kind of completes the title and gives them the date of the event as well. So 4th of July, please join us at the Newell's at 2 o'clock. And it's going to be food, fun, and fireworks. My three favorite things for Independence Day. Have a great Wednesday, you guys. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.